Good morning everyone. Today I shall discuss a very interesting topic, the Rutherford's atomic model associated with the chapter The Structure of an Atom. The plum pudding model of an atom was one of the most widely accepted models for understanding the structure of an atom. However, several experiments performed by the scientists to study the atomic structure showed interestingly different results, thereby contradicting the plum pudding model discovered by J.J. Thomson. This led many scientists to reconsider the structure of an atom and study it again. Around 1911, British physicist Ernst Rutherford carried out the famous gold foil experiment to study the structure of an atom. The experimental setup for the Rutherford's atomic model looked like this. And this is the block where the charged, where the alpha particle, that is the charged helium nucleus, is being taken, and through this orifice the alpha particle would hit the gold foil, a very thin sheet of the gold foil which is taken, and these are the observations which has been obtained, and the most of the alpha particles traveled in straight lines, some deflected their original path and some others rebounded. Now, why did alpha, first and foremost thing is that why did Rutherford select the alpha particle at the first place? Actually, the alpha particles have very high energy and heavier as well. So, if we say that the atom is a that the atom is a pudding of positively charged particles with electrons embedded in it, the particles will travel in straight line through it. This is obvious because the heavier particles will pierce through the lighter pudding structure of the atom and pass through it. And this was what Rutherford thought. For this reason, the helium nucleus having the greater mass and energy as compared to that of proton has been considered for this alpha particle experiment. Next, why did he choose a very thin gold foil? Now, the really thin gold foil was estimated to contain around 1000 atoms. Lesser atoms would mean a more convenient experiment for this setup. A fluorescent screen, this semicircular fluorescent screen is taken, because since the screen will glow or emit fluorescent light whenever the alpha particles will hit it. So this is how the alpha particles would be traced. Considering the plum pudding model, and it was expected that most of the alpha particles would travel in straight line. However, Rutherford was astonished to see the results. Now, why was Rutherford astonished to see the results? This is because of the fact that most of the alpha particles passed in the straight line and hit the detector. Some got deflected by small angles, and very few alpha particles rebounded its path, as it is being depicted in this particular diagram. Now, what are the conclusions that can be drawn from this? Most of the space of an atom is empty. This is one of the conclusions. Now, why the most of the space of an atom is empty? This is because most of the alpha particle traversed in straight line without any, because it did not encounter any sort of deflection from any other particles. So this has been concluded. Secondly, the positive charge is concentrated at the center of an atom, and this is why a few of the alpha particles rebounded, and most of the alpha particles and some of the alpha particles deflected. There must be a positive charge concentrated in the center of the atom, which is regarded as the nucleus, where the entire mass of the atom is said to have been concentrated. Electrons revolve around the nucleus in the circular paths. So from after studying this, Rutherford came into the inference that the plum pudding model, which was used earlier, is inaccurate. So even though Rutherford's model has certain drawbacks, we will discuss it in our next section. So what we have learned from this? The plum pudding model, the drawbacks of the plum pudding model, and what has led other scientists to work on the alternative model of the atom, and the conclusions associated with the Rutherford's atomic model. We shall discuss further regarding the Rutherford's atomic drawbacks of the Rutherford's atomic model in the next video. Thank you. That's all for today.